In today's video, I'm gonna talk about the weight you lift and how that contributes to your back pain. Get up and get down, get up and get down. Hey guys, thanks so much for stopping by Squat University. This is part three on our Fix Your Back series. We're focusing right now on the evaluation process, which is key for fixing back pain. You need to know why your back pain is there in the first place. Now, we've talked about posture. We've talked about the different movements of your spine and how that relates and triggers your pain. If you haven't seen those videos yet, go back, check them out. Today's video is all about load, the amount of weight that you lift and how that affects your back pain. This can be very, very important for my weightlifters or powerlifters that have pain whenever they're lifting. So I'm gonna have Ed come over. Today, we're gonna talk about two specific tests that you can use, things that I use every single day when I'm evaluating someone with back pain. Now, the first one we're gonna do is called a kettlebell raise test. Basically, I'm gonna give Ed something, let's see, this is about 12 kilos, so we got 20 something pounds right here. Doesn't need to be extremely heavy, but I'm just gonna have him hold it down by his hips. Now, I'll often ask someone, do you have pain in this position? Just holding a little bit of weight. Then I'm gonna have him raise the weight out in front and hold it right there. Now from this position, because the weight is this much further away from his body, we're creating a longer moment arm, we're creating more torque on his spine, we're adding load to his spine right here. Okay, you can bring it back down. Now, whenever I would do that, I then ask, what happened to your pain? Did raising that weight out in front trigger more pain? Did your pain go up in intensity? If he said yes, I'm gonna say, all right, let's next brace your core, create stability, and then raise the weight. So I'll have Ed do it one more time. So I'll say, brace your core like I'm about to punch you right in the stomach, tighten up right here. Now raise your weight right out in front, hold it right there. Did that change your pain? For some people, that would, or he would say, yes, that felt better. I had less pain with that. What that's telling me is that his spine right now would be load intolerant because the weight affects and triggers his pain. But a helpful cue for him to fix his pain will be learning stability, how to stiffen his spine. That's gonna be very, very helpful for allowing his body to recover and then become more resilient to that trigger in the future. So things for him like the McGill Big Three are gonna be extremely helpful during his rehab process. So that's the first test for load tolerance. The second test is going to be the heel drop test. This is for dynamic forces. So this is gonna mimic if someone was running, box jumps, catching a clean, basically anything where there's a quick force going up through the spine. We're gonna see how that affects their body. So I'm gonna have Ed come up on his toes and then smack his heels hard on the ground. Basically send a shockwave up his spine. And I would say, what does that do to your pain? So let's try it one more time, up and then smack hard. Okay, and I'll ask, okay, do you have pain with that? Now, for someone that has pain with this motion, let's do it one more time so everyone can see. So I'll then ask him, do you have pain with that? Does that force create pain? If he said yes, I'll then have him brace his core and do that one more time. So brace the core nice and strong and do the heel drop test. Now, two things. Let's say first, yes, bracing the core took his pain away. What does that mean? Well, again, that means that having stability in his spine limited the amount of movement. His body was able to better tolerate the forces of dynamic load through the spine. And again, doing things like the McGill Big Three and learning how to brace properly would be a very important part of his rehab. If, however, he did that heel drop test and he had the exact same amount of pain, it did not take his pain away, it means that he's still very load compromised. And for him, during his training, right now, he needs to completely remove things that are creating those dynamic forces. So that means no running, no box jumps, no heavy cleans, things that are gonna create and mimic those loads on the spine. We need to remove those because his spine is very load compromised. Now, an important thing that's very helpful to see, whenever he does that heel drop test, do that one more time. So drop up, come down, he has pain. I say brace the core, do it one more time. Less pain. Now, here's a very simple thing that can be helpful to understand really what's going down at the spine. This is a great model from Dynamic Disc Designs. And you can see this specific segment of the spine has a little bit less inherent stiffness. Now, it can happen because of a number of things. We could have a disc bulge, an older disc bulge, an end plate fracture. Basically, something has created instability in this specific disc. It's lost a little bit of stiffness. Now, you can see when I create movement of the spine, more motion occurs at this specific segment. Now that mimics what happens whenever you do a heel drop test, is you're creating a little bit of micro movement at the spine, which is triggering pain. But then when I had Embrace, we're creating a little bit of compression and it limits those painful micro movements occurring. So that's often the case whenever you have someone that has pain with the heel drop test that then gets better with core stability or a brace over the top. Often a trigger for their pain is a little bit of instability in the spine, and that shows you just how important core stability is during the rehab process to take away the pain and help rebuild basically the resiliency to those specific movements down the road. So that is it for this part of the video. Basically, this is our part three of how to evaluate your spine. So as you have gone through these three parts, you should have uncovered different movement diagnoses based on postures, motions, and loads. What actually is triggering your pain? Because everyone's gonna be a little bit different. Remember, this isn't all in your head. There's a why behind every single person's back pain. So you should have uncovered and been able to make some notes that your pain is maybe more flexion related. We call that a flexion intolerance. More extension related, or extension with rotation. Does your pain come out with movement of the spine, or maybe your pain comes out a little bit more with loads applied to your spine? And that will help change the rehab process early on to decrease your back pain and help you move on from this. So I hope you guys enjoyed our entire series so far on the evaluation process. If you'd like to learn a little bit more, head on over to squatuniversity.com, check out how to screen your back pain, and you can really dive into the science and a little bit more into everything that goes on in the actual screening process for back pain. Until next time, guys, happy squatting.
They say that energy flows where attention goes, so I pay no mind. Why waste my time with all these negative cats scratching? So caught up in their egos, these people have lost.